If you've ever wondered whether bioplastic is an eco-friendly alternative to traditional plastic, you'll find out the answer in this video. First, let's understand what bioplastic means. It's often misunderstood that bioplastics are always biodegradable, but that's not always the case. A material could be called a bioplastic if it is either bio-based or biodegradable, or if it features both properties. Bio-based means the plastic is made from renewable biomass like vegetable oil or cornstarch instead of fossil fuels. Biodegradable means the material can break down into organic materials after use. A bioplastic may have either one of these properties, but not necessarily both. So let's first take a look at bio-based plastics in detail, and then we will move on to biodegradable plastics. There are many different types of bio-based plastics, but one of the common types is PLA or polylactic acid, which is made using renewable raw materials like cornstarch, tapioca or sugarcane. The significant advantage of bio-based plastics is the low carbon footprint. Fossil fuel-based plastics have a high carbon footprint, and the entire process, right from extraction to disposal, has damaging effects on the environment. Though the production of bio-based plastics may also use fossil fuels for things like energy and transportation, the overall consumption is lower, which is better for the environment. However, there is one major issue with the production of PLA. Since it's made from raw materials like corn, we need to think if it is ethical to use all those crops from the farm for bioplastics, when it could rather feed people in need. The land requirement, deforestation, water consumption, and fertilizer use to produce these raw materials also contribute to the overall environmental impact. But PLA is just one type of bio-based plastic, and there are other types and ways to produce them. For example, some researchers have found ways to make bio-based plastics out of food waste. Such plastics can be a good way to make use of waste materials while providing an alternative to traditional plastics. Different kinds of bio-based plastics may have different properties, which can affect the way they have to be disposed at the end of their life. Bio-based plastics like PLA are recyclable, but most times they can't be recycled along with other conventional plastics. If they do get mixed with other plastics when they're not supposed to, it may contaminate the entire recycling process. So it's not a good idea to place them in the usual plastic recycling bin. It's not easy to identify the recycling requirements because bioplastics fall under the number 7 plastic resin code, which simply includes all plastics that don't fall under the categories 1 to 6. Including nylon, acrylic, and mixed plastics, among others. Many recyclers do not accept number 7 plastics for recycling. So there's a good chance that bio-based plastics will not get recycled, even though they technically can be. Some of these plastics like PLA and PHA are also known to biodegrade given the right conditions. But there are also some bio-based plastics like bio-based PET that cannot biodegrade. Interestingly, there are some fossil fuel-based plastics that claim to be biodegradable as well because of their chemical structure. So how can we, as a consumer, find out whether a product we buy is actually biodegradable or not? Sadly, we cannot simply trust the word biodegradable on the product because it may be misleading when there is no specific time frame or requirements mentioned. This is because technically everything will eventually biodegrade given enough time, even conventional plastics. But whether it may take 2 weeks or a million years, we may never know. Those products marked as compostable may be a better option. There are certifications like the seedling logo, which can help consumers in being sure of the product's claims. But again, there is a catch here. Most of the compostable plastics require very specific conditions to be composted. This can only happen in specific industrial composting sites, which may not be accessible to many. only a very, very small percentage of these compostable plastics are suitable for home composting. If the materials are just thrown in the trash or litter, they may take too long to biodegrade or they never might. In that case, they might just be as harmful as conventional plastics. Here, I'd like to talk about another type of plastic you may have come across. These are the ones marketed as degradable or oxo-degradable. These are not bioplastics. There is no proper proof that they will degrade into organic materials. Degradable just means the plastic will fragment into smaller and smaller pieces of microplastics that are very harmful to nature. Sometimes special additives are added to conventional plastic to accelerate this kind of fragmentation in specific conditions. Oxo-degradable plastic fragments more quickly when exposed to heat and light. Photo-degradable plastic fragments more quickly in sunlight. These kinds of plastics are not even suitable for long-term reuse, and though technically recyclable, they pose several challenges there as well. Overall, they are probably more dangerous than conventional plastics. So the question you've all been waiting for: are bioplastics a better alternative to traditional plastics? The sustainability of bioplastics will depend on what we use them for. Today, we commonly find bioplastics in disposable items like straws and bags. If there is no proper waste management in place, they might just end up in the landfill or ocean and pollute the environment. For this reason, I think it is best to avoid disposable items as much as possible, whatever material they may be made of. Also, it may not be worth it to spend a lot of energy and resources on a product that is meant to be thrown away within minutes of use. However, there are many other areas where plastics prove to be a very useful material, like in several reusable products, in the medical industry, and so on. Bioplastics can play a significant role in creating an eco-friendly future for such products. However, they will hardly make any difference without the proper infrastructure built around them. We need to have proper recycling systems, composting facilities, and the means to implement these practices to truly benefit from the advantages. Companies should also work towards providing transparent and unambiguous information about their products to customers so that it is clear what the product is made of, how it can be used, and how it can be disposed after use. Bioplastics do have the potential to be a good alternative to traditional plastics if we work on all these limitations. Plastic has become such an integral part of our lives, and sometimes we are not even aware of all the plastic we use. Subscribe to the channel and watch this video about 15 everyday things that contain plastic. You might be surprised with many items on the list.